must know that when the name of your Sheikh, of my Sheikh, of our Sheikh, Hazrat Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani al-Rabbani, rahmatullah ta'ala, is mentioned, their soul becomes wujud in this matter. This is the first yaqeen and the first fundamental part of aqeedah and yaqeen. Our yaqeen is that when we mention the name of the great Sheikh's soul becomes wujud in this matter. So when Brother Sheikh Salim said that this gathering has the tawajjuh, the spiritual concentration of the Sheikh, is because the Sheikh is wujud in these mehfils. Otherwise, these mehfils can never go on. That's the successful mission of the great Sheikh, Hazrat Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani. Wherever these gatherings are, Allah will send the rahmat down in these gatherings. Allah will send the souls of the shayukh of the Silsila Ali Naqshbandiya to these mehfils. Even if there is nobody in these mehfils, even if no person came in this mehfil, wallah ba khuda, all of the souls of the Naqshbandiya Aliya, all of the shayukh will be wujud in this mehfil. Even if nobody came to this mehfil, all of the souls and the ruh of all of the sheikhs of Silsila Ali Naqshbandiya will be wujud in this matter. And I'm saying this with 101% yaqeen.
Allah Akbar. Allah.
Whenever I tell something, I'm only telling this from my own heart. A person never speaks if he does not know the haqiqat within himself.
Allah.
Many people speak. Hazrat Sheikh Mawlana Nazim al-Haqqani said, there is many scholars out there that have much knowledge, but they do not have the wisdom. They do not have the wisdom. The wisdom Allah only grants to His awliya. The awliya Allah, they have the wisdom, then they have the ilm, then they change the hearts of the people. Then they change the hearts of the people. Why is it that the scholars cannot change their hearts? Because they do not have the wisdom.
Subhanallah.
Allah bestows wisdom upon the friends of Allah. And Hazrat Sheikh Mawlana Nazim al-Haqqani, let me tell you, was and is my Sheikh too. I have two Sheikhs. My own Sheikh and Hazrat Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani. And the reason why I say this, my brothers, is when I was given ijazah in this Silsila Ali Naqshbandi on Khilafah, Hazrat Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani was mujood, and my murshid again was mujood. And this ijazah came from two Sultan al-Awliyas. So two of these Sultan al-Awliyas are my sheikhs.
Allahu Akbar.
Let me tell you, last 2 weeks ago when I said that you have to connect your heart with Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani, you have to connect your heart. Alhamdulillah, from that day, until today, every single night, every single day, my heart is connected to Hazrat Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani. Every single night.
Subhanallah.
Wallah ba khuda, every single night, I am at the grave of the great Sheikh. Every single night, I am at the grave, and I am sending them salam, and I am sending fatiha to them, and I am sitting with the shayukh, Hazrat Sheikh Muhammad Effendi, and I am sitting with Hazrat Sheikh Bahuddin, and I am sitting with Hazrat Sheikh Adnan, and I am sitting with Hazrat Sheikh Hisham al-Kabani. Every single night. So these things are not impossible, they are possible.
Alhamdulillah.
But you have to have the yaqeen and aqeedah. This is what Sheikh Salim is trying to teach you. He's trying to teach you, come to these gatherings of zikr, open your heart with Allah's remembrance, and let the muhabbat, and let the concentration and connection of your heart be connected with the heart of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim al-Haqqani. Let me tell you one last thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Hadith al-Qudsi, very important, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said through the blessed tongue of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when my servant comes to me, comes near to me, a hand span, I come to him an arm's length. When my servant comes to me a hand span, I come to him an arm's length. When he comes to me walking, I come to him running. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying it through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let me tell you what Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani said about this. Hadrat Shaykh Mawlana Nazim al-Haqqani said, When my servant, my murid, comes to me by one step, I come to my murid with 99 steps.
Allah, subhanallah.
Hazrat Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani said, when my murid comes to me with one step, I come to him with 99 steps.
Subhanallah.
Come to the Shaykh with one step. This is all it takes. Come to the Shaykh with one step, and the Shaykh will come to you with 99 steps. Hazrat Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani was the master of masters.
Allah.
He was the master of wisdom. He was the master of spirituality. He is the master of all of the awliya. He's the sultan of all of the awliya. And when a sultan comes upon this dunya, let me tell you, every single thing comes under his control. Every single thing. Even the rains come under his control. The clouds come under his control. The mountains, the way they move, come under the control of the Sultan al-Awliya. All of the Awliya Allah, the Abdal, all of the 40 Abdal come under the control of the Sultan al-Awliya. Nothing moves on this dunya without the Sultan, without the ijazah of Sultan al-Awliya. That means every single human, every single insan is actually under the order of the Sultan al-Awliya. This is why Sultan al-Awliya takes, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani al-Rabbani took the burdens of all of the world. Not just the Ummah, took the burdens of all of the people of the world, whether they were in oppression or whether they were in torment, or whether they were the people of this country living large. Every single burden, every single worry, every single taklif, every single punishment came upon the back of Hadrat Sultan al-Awliya Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani. And imagine, can you take that burden of the world? Nobody can take the burden of the world, let me tell you. But Hadrat Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani was the Sultan al-Awliya. His eyes were pearls of knowledge.
Allah.
And I swear by the name of Allah, when I sat in front of the Sultan al-Awliya and they opened their eyes and you see the color of their eyes change. Who saw this? Who saw the colors of their eyes change? One minute they're green. The next second, the eyes turn blue. Then they turn hazel. Then they turn like a purpley color, purpley blue.
SubhanAllah.
This was a significance of the ilm, the wisdom of the great Shaykh. His eyes were pearls of knowledge. His words were words of wisdom. His actions were the actions of the Sunnah of Rasulullah. And many people did not know this. You've seen the video when Hadrat Shaykh Mawlana Nazim al-Haqqani used to listen to the name Muhammad. And the great Shaykh Mawlana Nazim al-Haqqani used to stand up in adab, in respect of the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Many new murids did not understand why. They thought, you know, maybe it's the Muhammad for the name. No. Hazrat Mawlana Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani stood up every single time because Muhammad Rasulullah became present in front of them.
SubhanAllah.
The name, it wasn't just the name, it was the insan, the whole body of Rasulullah used to come in front of Shaykh Nazim al-Haqqani.
SubhanAllah.
How could you will be sitting down when the Rasulullah is standing up in front of him. This is the reason why Mawlana Sheikh Nazm al-Khani used to stand up. Even though they were 90 years old, 90, 91, 92 years old now that they passed away, but despite the age, they still stood up in front of Sayyidina Rasulullah. Many people did not understand this, because the great Shaykh's understanding was beyond the clouds, beyond the heavens. Allah dressed them with the color of Allah, Sifqatullah, the color of Allah. Dosto, you know, I try not to talk in the past tense. We try to talk in the present. I don't like to say that was, we should be talking about that this is the great Shaykh. The great Shaykh is the master of wisdom. The great Shaykh is the master of spirituality. The great Shaykh is the master of knowledge, the master of ruhaniyat, the master of silsila alimish bandiya. We don't talk about the past, we talk about is. Because Mawlana Sheikh Nazm al-Haqqani is majood right here in this
place.
And I swear by the name of Allah, you close your eyes at night. Think about the smile. Think about the beautiful smile of the great Sheikh. Think about beautiful words that came out from their blessed mouth. Think about how they treated everybody. Everybody took one part of muhabbat. From the great Sheikh. Yeah. Sheikh Saleem took much muhabbat from the great Sheikh, subhanAllah. Let's sit with brother Sheikh Saleem and learn about the life of Mawlana Sheikh Nazm. Yeah. If those people did not have the opportunity to sit and to listen to Mawlana Sheikh, then you should sit with those people who sat with Mawlana Sheikh. You should sit with those people who sat with Mawlana Sheikh, because they will tell you about the life of the great Sheikh. Allahu Akbar. It's my unfortunate that the great Sheikhs, they gave me ijazah to move away from Bradford. Otherwise I would have stayed there, but the great Sheikhs, the Sultan al-Awliyas, they said that my mission is somewhere else in the south, so subhanAllah, wherever they send us, that's where we go.
Alhamdulillah.
But I swear, my heart has always been in these gatherings of zikr for over 20 years, my brother. Over 20, 21 years. Yeah, we have been doing these mehfils of zikr.
Alhamdulillah.
Over 20 years, I have had my heart connected with the awliya Allah.
Allah.
Yeah, and a person who does the hidmah, and who serves Mawlana Sheikh Nazm al-Haqqani said, every man wants to become a saint of Allah. Sainthood. Everybody wants sainthood. Before you attain sainthood, you have to attain servanthood. You have to attain servanthood. The way to serve Allah, first you have to serve the friends of Allah. When you serve the friends of Allah, when you serve them, when you do the hidmah, when you give them gifts, when you dabar them, when you give them your love, when you give them their ish, when you bend down and juk down at their feet, when you grab their shoes, yeah, because the ilm can only come when you grab their shoes. My great Shaykh used to say, ke o ilm. You have to put your head where their shoes are. You have to put your head where their shoes are. When you put your head where their shoes are, then they lift your head up. Then they lift your head up, and then they look at you, look into your eyes, and then they feed you with that knowledge what they have. This is how the ilm of ruhaniya, the ilm of ruhaniyat, sisla aliyah naqshbandiya
happens.
People are too proud today with their egos. Put your egos at the feet of the awliya. This is where the true knowledge is.
Allah
give us that amr di tawfiq. Give us, because we are all weak, Allah give us the strength that we may do what the great awliya have told us. And Allah always keep us in the muhabba, the muhabba of Hazrat Shaykh Mawlana Nazm al-Haqqani. Wa akhir du'ana ila alhamdulillah. Amin.
الله.